KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
Well, going into Easter weekend, so far everything's right on schedule. A weak cold front coming through brought all the rain up in Northern California. We thought, well, maybe makes it to Monterey. Hasn't even gotten there yet. Been raining pretty good in Santa Cruz, though. About a third of an inch of rain there and about a half an inch in some parts of the Santa Cruz Mountains. But farther south, it's pretty much just falling apart at the seams. Here's a closer look at Doppler radar. The light blue is stuff that just barely makes it to the ground. We had a few light showers, just barely enough for the, you know, intermittent wipers, except around Santa Cruz up to about Capitola. But that's settling down right now. As you can see, that's all thinning out. So not much is likely going to make it all the way down to Monterey, but just in case, we'll keep it in the mix for the night. Temperatures cool in Santa Cruz County today, mostly 50s, not more than about 55, that in Watsonville. Overnight, we had a few mid to upper 30s, as expected, 40s around the peninsula, 62 in Seaside, Carmel by the Sea, 56 in Big Sur, though, and 58 in Marina. And Salinas checked in with 59, and then we had a couple of mid-60s in the Salinas Valley with the help of a little southerly wind. All pretty much as planned. A little chilly in the morning, but we're going to lose that before too long. 57, pretty much popular in the Santa Clara Valley. Right now, it's 49 in Redding, 35 at Lake Tahoe. And as Mike Tissell told you, you don't want to go there tonight. Tomorrow will be a little bit easier travel, but you still want to go prepared for those winter conditions again Sunday afternoon and Sunday night, the next storm system coming in. Southern California, 60s and 70s at this hour, so nobody's getting all that hot right now. Yeah, except around parts of the southern tier of the country, we're still doing 75. In Dallas, 65 in St. Louis, 54 in New York. Highs were 81 in St. Louis and Chicago today, but behind it, look at that, 46 in Denver and Boise. And when you have a boundary like that of warm and cold air, particularly the cold air aloft and the warm air near the surface, you get thunderstorms. Boom, there they go. We had some damage out of that all the way from Oklahoma into, well, it's getting into St. Louis right now, stretching all the way up into Wisconsin and into Kansas. They had some damaging weather. That'll continue to track across the Great Lakes tomorrow, but not be too much of a significant weather maker, likely. Just some rain here and there. The Pacific Northwest had some snow in the northern Rockies. Another system queuing up upstream. That's one we've been talking about for the last couple of days here. First one dies on the vine, flat high pressure behind it. That's your Saturday. No problem. This system will also move to the west, but it'll be a little bit stronger. So we're looking for that to sag into our sky on Easter Sunday. But most of it will wait till most everything is done that you need to get done on Easter Sunday. Saturday, 1 o'clock, you're okay. Sunday at 1 o'clock is just starting to work into the Bay Area. Maybe a few scout showers in the Santa Cruz Mountains. Most of it's going to come through at night. So right about sundown and beyond, we'll get most of the rain done, probably quarter to a third of an inch for the valleys, maybe an inch or so for the mountains. And then Monday, just leftover showers. Tuesday, high pressure comes back in. Greg Lulka will keep an eye on that for you over the weekend as well. Microcast takes what's left of this front right out of your sky, sunshine, and then some high clouds coming in by tomorrow night in advance of that next front. No huge issues with wind. We'll back them off tonight and then give you a little northwesterly breeze. And as we mentioned, for the salmon fishermen, be easy conditions in the morning. And then on Sunday, you may want to get into port by midday before the next system starts making itself known. Overnight lows, 50s for highs. We'll get the overnight lows in the 50s before too long. That's for the Bay Area. But we'll do 60s for San Jose all the way down to Hollister. Salinas Valley might even get up to about mid to upper 60s in a few spots there at the high point of the day. And we'll figure top 50s to low 60s and around the Monterey Peninsula. All that's not looking all that bad either. Huh? A little bit chilly up in the mountains, still a few mid to upper 30s and 40s around Santa Cruz, Watsonville, but top 50s, low 60s will do it. Mostly cloudy, still could be a couple of light showers about Monterey North, but that's about it. That's gone here in a few hours. As you saw on the radar, not much left of that guy. Partly cloudy, that's your Saturday, not bad. And Sunday, starting to cloud up. Got a chance of afternoon showers, mostly Moss Landing North, and by evening time it starts to move south to Monterey. The rain comes in overnight. We'll leave a few showers in for Monday. So the heaviest rain is going to be Sunday night. After that, we're going to be looking at a lot of starry nights again. And by day, well, it's looking good. The Easter Bunny, he was changed from his pink costume yesterday to his brown costume, getting all suited up here. And he's happy because Sunday morning, Easter egg hunts and people going out to church and all that stuff, no big issues. Clouds, like say, in the afternoon and like Sunday night is really the time to snuggle up by the fire. But you'll want to change the fire to the ceiling fan, it looks like, by the middle of the week, because we're going to be doing 60s and 70s again, Dan.
Wow.
So it's going to be moving on up.